Senator Rand Paul, member of the Senate Foreign Relations Committee. Senator, good day to you. I saw you on Monday afternoon from Helsinki talking to CNN. That was a firework in itself. What do you think about what John Brennan's doing right now? Let's start there.
You know, John Brennan started out his adulthood by voting for the Communist Party presidential candidate. He's now ending his career by showing himself to be the most biased, bigoted, over-the-top, hyperbolic, sort of unhinged director of the CIA we've ever had. And really, it's an insult to everything about our government to have a former head of the CIA calling the president treasonous just because he doesn't like him. But realize that Brennan, you know, I filibustered Brennan. I tried to keep Brennan from ever being the leader of the CIA. But realize that Brennan and Clapper are known for wanting to expand the authority of the intelligence agencies to grab up everyone's information, including Americans. And so I don't have a lot of respect for these people. Even before they decided to go on hating the president, I disliked these people because they wanted to grab up so much power and use it against the American people.
Okay, now, you characterized it very well the other day. You said if you've been investigated for a year and a half on claims that you don't find founded, then what are you supposed to think? And that was the perspective of the president on Monday, and I know that's what you believe. Here's the tweet. Some people hate the fact that I got along well with President Putin of Russia. They would rather go to war than see this. It's called Trump derangement syndrome. I think you as a doctor diagnosed that, did you?
Yeah. Well, you know, I think the best way to look at this, and I've told people, is that, you know, Reagan called out the Soviet empire for being the evil empire, tear down the wall. He had very aggressive rhetoric, but then Reagan did sit down with Gorbachev, and I'm guessing in their personal meetings, he didn't call him an evil tyrant. He didn't storm around and shake his fist. They had rapport in order to get to four major strategic arms reductions where we reduced nuclear weapons, reduced the threat of nuclear war. So I think that Trump responded at times with, you know, bold rhetoric against some of these foreign leaders, against North Korea, but then being willing to sit down with them really is in the mold of what Reagan did. And I think
most of these people are just deranged with Trump, and
I think that's why they're crazy.
So much of this issue comes back to him and how he's trying to sell it, though. I know what he's thinking. He's saying, I want it. Get over it. Don't try and take it away from me on illegal grounds. But he's got to say it that way. And
right.
If he doesn't say it that way, people don't remember where he's coming from. And I think that was a lot about what happened on Monday.
Right. I agree. And I think a lot of it is that the president sees the Mueller investigation. He sees all these accusations from partisan Democrats, Hillary Clinton saying, oh, he colluded with the Russians. But then he also sees that the only people who actually we know colluded with the Russians were Hillary Clinton, who paid a British agent, who then paid Russians for information for this dossier. So he is feels like the intelligence community cooked up a political or partisan investigation. But also part of the Mueller investigation is something that should be investigated, and that is who hacked into Hillary Clinton's emails. And so I think
he sees the part where
he's accused of collusion, and he responds to that, and it taints the whole investigation, whereas there is part of the Mueller investigation that is actually legitimate, and then there's part of it that is just simply a partisan attack on the president.
A lot of nuance, and you clarified it well. You're going to talk to Mike Pompeo in a hearing next week. I don't think Mike Pompeo should wait until next week to talk. I mean, he was in the bilateral meeting. We still do not know, we do not have a good idea as to what happened in those meetings. Why not come out and talk today?
I think that we will hear more over time. I plan on talking to the president in the next week or two by going to the White House and talking to him about the meeting in Helsinki. And I think they will begin to talk more about it. But realize that the beginning of diplomacy isn't always splashed across the front pages. Sometimes diplomacy goes on for a year, 2 years at a time until we finally get a breakthrough that can be made public.
Senator, thank you for your time. Hope you come back soon, okay?
Thank you.
Rand Paul, the Republican from Kentucky there on the Hill. Thank you, Senator.